Hello everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the counters that help me put the indices of your elements on the web page. Before I discuss the counters, I just want to show you the web page on the right hand side. So I have so many paragraphs and I have some headings together with a list which is already ordered in some way. Okay, so how can I make this web page? I just use the HTML file on the left hand side. So let me show you the web page content followed by the HTML code. So I have some paragraphs. The paragraphs are shown here. And then I'm going to have another division that puts a lot of headings. So you can treat these headings as my table of contents of a certain book. Okay. And finally, I would have the third division, which is called Multilevel. And inside this division, I have an ordered list starting from here to the end of the web page. And inside the ordered list, I have so many list elements. And inside some list elements, I'm also able to contain another ordered list. And inside this inner ordered list, I have some list elements, okay? So here, I just want to generate a subsection with an inner ordered list element inside an LI element, okay? So this is the situation of having inner level of the ordered list inside a certain list, okay? So I just continue setting up my ordered list, which contains some ordered list again. So you can see on the web page that the indented ordered list would come from the inner ordered list that I show here. Okay. So these two lines are referring to these two list elements inside the inner ordered list. Okay. So I do the same thing for many of my other list elements of my very outer ordered list. Okay, so that's why I will have this kind of pattern that can be shown on the web page. Okay, and at the end, I just have some empty spaces to let me scroll the web page a bit easier. Okay, then I'm going to show you the ways to add the numbers onto the web page. So let me open the CSS file as well. Okay, here I'm going to show you the meaning of a counter first. Counters can be incremented according to its location of the elements. So that means the indices that describes a certain element can be incremented automatically by means of the counters provided by the CSS. Okay, so how can I show you the counters to you? I'm going to set up the counter to be zero at the beginning of my demonstration. So for the body element, I can do something like this now. So for the body section here, I just want to reset the counter pertaining to my paragraphs that are treated later. Okay. So paragraph here is a variable. So I'm going to demonstrate the way to use this variable. So you can see that the counter for the paragraph is already reset to zero. And let me go to the division shown here. And I'm going to look for the paragraphs inside this division. And before showing the paragraphs, I want to show the indices. How can I do that? I can simply add a few lines inside this selector. Okay, you can see the meaning of the paragraph variable a bit clearer right now. So I want to increment the indices one by one by showing one more paragraph inside my current division. And you can see that before showing the paragraph content, I have already added some text controlled by the content attribute here. Paragraph followed by the counter function and followed by the colon together with a space. So this part shown on the web page is the content added by the content attribute, okay? And the function called counter is simply helping me to generate the indices. So the paragraph variable is changed according to the position of my paragraphs. So for the first paragraph, it has an index of 1. For the second one, it has an index of 2, and so on. The reason it starts with 1 is because I already set up the counter for my paragraph variable to be 0 before I enter the first division. You see, I set up the body element to reset the counter for this variable called paragraph. So counter is a function to help me generate the indices. When I set up the indices to be 0 at the beginning, I'm going to make use of the counter function to help me generate the numbers automatically. And of course, I can simply set up the font style for my content. So now it is set as italic. So you can see that it is not that difficult to simply enter the numbers generated by the CSS file automatically. So now I'm going to show you another way of adding the indices for some nested contents. So I have a table of contents here, and I'm going to show you the ways to add the indices appropriately for each heading shown here. So you see, I have H2 elements and H3 elements here. Okay, so the H3 elements are intended to have a subsection index. So how can I show this index to you? I can do it now. So the class is called nested, so that we go to the nested selector first. I set up the counter-reset attribute for the variable called chapter. So how can I make use of this variable to create the indices automatically? I can show you now. For the H2 elements, I want to also reset the counter because we want to show the subchapter indices. So before I go to the subchapter indices indicated by the H3 elements, I want to reset the subchapter variable to be 0 first. And then I'm going to make use of these two variables to do the indices for my H2 and H3 elements. So let me go to this selector. So before printing out the contents inside the H2 elements, I'm going to add the indices appropriately. Now you can see that the H2 headings have already put something before I do the printing of the headings. So the thing being printed here is controlled by the content attribute. So you see, I already make use of the chapter variable to do the indexing of my elements. So before I use the content attribute, I already set up the chapter variable to have an index with 0 before I enter the H2 elements. Okay, so in this case, when I go to the H2 elements, the counting will simply start with 1. So the first chapter is called chapter 1. The second chapter, which is the content of the second H2 heading, is simply called chapter 2. Same for chapter 3. And how can I add the subchapter indices? I can do something like this for my H3 elements. Okay, by this way, I can add the subtractor indices from my H3 headings. How can I do that? I call the chapter indices followed by the subchapter indices in this way. Of course, I need to make use of the counter functions to help me generate the indices accordingly. Okay, so the meaning of the subchapter is somewhere here. I already set up the subchapter to be 0 when I did not enter the H3 elements yet. I already set up the subchapter counter to be 0 when I just enter the H2 elements, which are shown here, here, and here. So after entering the H2 elements, I'm going to increment the subchapter variable one by one. So that's why I can show the subchapter indices accordingly. And you can see that I also make use of the chapter variable to help me add the chapter corresponding to each subchapter. Okay, so that is the way of combining two variables to set up the content value. Okay, finally, I'm going to show you the ways to add the indices on an ordered list which has so many ordered lists. How can I do that? Let me go to the content first, which is this division called multilevel. So when I want to enter a certain ordered list, I need to reset the counter as follows. Now I don't want to show the numbers provided by the ordered list. I just want to show the numbers that are controlled by my following code. So that's why I need to remove the list styles. And you see, I already set up a variable called section, which will become my counter. And at this stage, the counter is set to be 0. So that means when I enter the ordered list element, my counter called section is set as 0. And how can I show the numbers? I can show the numbers next to each list element as follows. Okay, so before I print the contents of the list elements, I need to show the contents controlled by the value of the content attribute. So you see, I used the function called counters rather than counter. Okay, so what does it mean by the function called counters? When I use counters, it is able to help me generate such an inner level of my ordered list. Okay, so this ordered list is in the inner level of my outer ordered list. So when I enter an inner ordered list, I have to set the counter to be 0 first, and then I'm going to do the increment of the indices by following the position of the list elements inside my ordered list. So by means of the counters function, the section number can be incremented appropriately according to your level of your ordered lists. Okay, so after I enter the section number, I will add a dot, and after the dot, I'm going to show you the indices for my inner ordered list elements. Okay, so that's the way of setting up the numbers according to your position of your ordered list elements. So we see that for the third point, I have one sub point coming from the third point. And for the fifth point, I have one big point called 5.1. And inside 5.1, I'm able to show 5.1.1 and 5.1.2. So I have two more points inside and in the ordered list shown here. So this is the third level of the ordered list. So that's why I have three numbers to indicate my position of the elements. Okay, so when I go outside the ordered list, I will simply resume the indexing with only two digits. and the digits are separated by one dot shown here. And when I simply leave the ordered list here, I'm going to show the final list element with just one number. So by means of counters function, we're able to produce this kind of indexing according to the position of your ordered list inside a given very outer ordered list. So this video has discussed a lot of things. We have to notice the counter-reset attribute, we have to increment the counters wisely, and we have to include a variable that helps me do the counting by means of the counter function and the counters function. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.